Hey, now the secret part. In this particular card trick, you what they call force a card on someone. That means you know what they're going to choose, or you make them choose something. I really like that concept of, I force you to choose that card, because people think, wait a minute, you didn't force me to do nothing. Oh, okay. But in a sense, you really do. There are several ways to what they call force a card. In other words, make them choose what you want. I'm just going to show you one right now. There are 52 cards in a deck. And this particular force is called the cross cut. Because I'll show you why. You can see they're all different here. I'm not going to force the card that I used the last time. Okay, it's pretty much shuffled. So, I'm going to force a two of hearts. You don't tell a person that you're gonna pretend like you don't know what they're gonna choose. So. You go like this and riffle the cards. You say stop. So they say stop, and then you look at them and you say, now look, I stopped whenever you said stop. And normally when you're talking to someone out of courtesy, you know, they'll look at you. You look at them in the eyes and they look at you in the eyes. And while they're doing that, that's when you do the magical movement. And so you say, you know, we stopped at where you wanted to stop. Here's where you wanted to stop. Here it is. And then we can talk about different ways to, I think the next video, how to reveal your card. Last time I had the same card there, at least when it worked. When it didn't work, I messed up. But I know already this is the two of hearts. So there's different ways to reveal it. I mean, you can write it on a piece of paper and say, I say you had a two of hearts, let's put it here, let's find out. You turn it over, lo and behold, it's a two of hearts. How did you do that? And in magic, you know you did a good job when they say, how did you do that? So, and there's two ways to answer that. There's a smart aleck way, and then there's a cute way. The cute way is, how did I do that? Very well, thank you. The smart aleck way to say, to answer that is, when they say, how did you do that? You say, can you keep a secret? Yeah, so can I. That's a smart aleck way. Now, did you notice that I put the two of hearts here? My hands are kind of dirty. Let me go wash my hands and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. You know, when you're doing what they call close-up magic, and that's another thing we can talk about, different types of magic, escape magic, mentalism, restaurant magic, which is basically close-up, and cards and coins are considered close-up magic. So anyway, you notice that I put that two of hearts. So the first thing you do, you kind of show that everything is different. I mean, different colors, different cards. And you take a real quick glance at that last card. Look, two hearts. So I know it's a two of hearts. Now, it's on top, huh? So normal speed, you go stop. Okay, now look. There's 52 cards, they're all different. You distract them, you have them look at you. And I don't know if you noticed where that top card went, but it went right here. But you say, this is the card that you stopped at, and I have a feeling it may be, it's a red card, it's not a high number, it's a low number. I think it's a heart of some kind. This is like the revealing in a mentalism way. It's red, it's maybe a heart, and I get a feeling like it's probably a two. I don't know, maybe. Maybe I'm wrong, but let's see. Well, lo and behold. Okay, so now, takes a little bit of time to get familiar with this move, but it's not that hard. Look, it's right here. You say stop, blah, 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 slow motion, huh? Blah, 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 blah. Da-da-da, da-da-dee, da-da-da. You said stop, I stopped, here's your card. And there it is. Now you may be thinking, nobody's gonna fall for that. That's too obvious. Not really, as long as you do this. You know what that card is. They say stop, and then right now, you look at them in the eye, and you tell them, okay, I stopped when you said stop, right? No, yeah, you did. Okay, we stopped here on your card. There it is. So it's called cross cut because you're cutting the cards and then you cross them like that. And there's the card. So it does take some practice. So, you know, I know so many people, they don't want to practice. I got the secret, da-da-da. And then I put it right here. And then, obvious. So, stop. Blah, 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 blah. You're talking to him, you tell him this and that, you tell him this and that. And then now if you go back to the first video, it'll be obvious. Because when you know what's going on, it's obvious what you did. I say you're going to stop at that one. Are you ready?
Stop.
No. I'll do it faster. I mean slower.
Stop.
Okay, look. 52 cards are all different. Here's where you stopped, right here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I said you were going to stop at a six of diamonds. You stopped at, say this too. In magic, there's an expression. The first time you do it, it's entertainment. The second time you do it to the same audience, the same trick, it's an education. So, bottom line is do this one time for the same person. Don't do any magic tricks twice before the same person. So now we'll use it on a different card this time. As you can see, they're all different. I mix them up. And sometimes you may say, oh, we got to get that joker out of here. Let me see. Well, I guess I took out the joker already. So. Okay, you say stop. Stop. Okay, now remember I told you could say stop anytime, and you did it, and I stopped at your number. I stopped at your card. So, I don't know, I'm going to try to, in my mind, I'm getting some expression, some impression. It's like a red card. It's got pointy things. It's like, well, I guess it's a diamond. And it's a number card. It's not a king or queen. It's not a low number, it's not a high number, maybe six, seven, or eight. Well, I think it's an eight of diamonds. I don't know. Let's see. Oh my gosh. Amazing! All right. Talk to you later.